Greetings and salutations, this is Gabriel, and today I'm going to be playing through Wonder Boy and Monster World. So, sort of a follow-up to Wonder Boy and the Dragon's Trap that I played through early. I think it was, well, I forget how many days ago it was, but it wasn't that, maybe less than a month, I don't know. Anyway. Let's not bore ourselves with meaningless facts, and start the game. So, Monster World was once a peaceful region. Then, the peace was shattered by an invading army of monsters. Monsters in Monster World. Who would have thought, right? A young man named Shion vowed to defeat them and make his land peaceful again. Alright, so, this is Shion. He is our pro tag for the entirety of the game. And first thing you notice right off the bat is he is slow. He is a slow person. He walks slow. He attacks fast, but he walks slow. He jumps slow. He's very slow person, just slow in general. So, once again, the world is in trouble, and the princess has been kidnapped from her pearl castle. So yeah, we got kidnapped princesses, worlds to save. It's a lot of what we've come to expect from these retro games. Alright, so she gives us some magic and an elixir. Let's go ahead and put on the magic, which we will I don't want to say never use magic, but magic isn't particularly useful. And we found some secret money. This game has a lot of secrets, just a lot of, it's a throwback to previous Wonder Boy games. Particularly the ones in the Monster series, just secret doors, jumping in random places to get money, that sort of thing. And unfortunately, I gotta farm some money because Shion is just so slow, and it's hard to do anything when you walk at the speed of molasses. So, I need at least, 30 gold, I believe. Which means killing these snakes. Oh, come on, snake. I need... And money drops are, well, they're random in the sense that you could get, like, 1 gold or 9 gold or... Okay, 6, almost there. Wow, right on the dot. I go over here, and you have a discriminating eye. The shopkeepers say this a lot. So that's leather boots, 30 gold. Yes. Alright, so. Slow Shion needs some new boots to walk faster, and yeah, it's an improvement, trust me. Now, this purple castle, where you got a missing princess problem. The entry is prohibited. Oh. Okay, fine. So, just keep on walking. Another noticeable attribute of Shion is that his attack range is pretty very short. It's pretty very short. You gotta get almost on top of enemies to kill them. And become second nature before long, so... But sometimes I'll crouch and attack to give off the mistaken idea that it has longer range, but... It's these muscle memory habits I've picked up from, you know, for playing a game on and off again for, what, since 1992, I think? Like, when I played this game for the first time. So... Lots of, precision platforming. And that's close. Now, when compared to Dragon's Trap, this game has much. It's the level design is much more diverse and interesting. It isn't just repeating hallways, and we get some interesting areas. Like we got this town that's invaded by enemies. Wow! Oh my gosh. Go ahead and just take a break at the end. Yes. So, definitely be sure to stop at the end, save the game, because, yeah, I slept well. Back when I first played through this game, I made the mistake of, never going to the end. So, I played all the way through this area, the first couple dungeons, and then I died. And since I hadn't saved, I had to start over. And I was close to an hour of progress, just gone to the ether, so... Ever since then, I try not to make that same mistake. And yeah, I'm farming again, because... A lot of the early game is just spent farming for new stuff. Because you... See that sign over there? I need a new weapon. So I'm gonna pick on these mushrooms for a bit. Alright, I think the spear... Spoiler alert, yes, I'm buying a spear. Right over here, my discriminating, wow, what is that? Okay, the small spear, 80 gold, yes. So, let's go ahead and put on the small spear. Gradius, I just realized that. I think it's supposed to be gladius, like as in the Roman era sword, but, you know. Instead, we get a shmup reference. I don't know. Alright, so, I got a spear. I can't use it inside this. So keep in mind that when you equip a spear, you can't use a shield. Alright, so, yeah. She's right. When a sword is equipped, Shion holds a shield in front of him, which deflects, like, projectiles and stuff pretty handy. Although... If I hold up and it repeatedly hit the attack button, I do this, which serves as a shield. But yeah. Alright, so let's go talk to this fairy queen. Alright, the Queen Eleonora has said that there are monsters in a cave just beyond the village. Alright, so she gives us Priscilla as an ally. She may be able to help you. I don't think she's going to be much help at all, though. So this game has a sort of ally system where you meet various friends along the journey, and they help out in their own way. Unfortunately, most of the time, they just don't do anything of worth. So... Like, so Priscilla here, she does this. You know, she's like, take that, and that, and that, and, you know, it's not doing anything. Slightly more useful are those very rare times where she'll make a heart appear out of nowhere to regain a little health, but, again, nothing... Like, right there! Thanks for the heart. We'll probably see that two or three more times before we leave and never see her again, so... Yeah, we're just gonna go through this forest. Painstakingly taking out every single mushroom because I want to buy some armor. Now we have this door, which is apparently locked by a musical note. So, okay, I must be missing something here. So just gotta double back and make sure I talk to everybody in town. Forgot the first rule of adventure games. Talk to everybody. Because everybody is important. So, start with you. Alright, so if it's the cave up ahead that you wish to know about, go ask Sonya. Okay? Now, how do I know who Sonya is? I don't. She just happens to be in here. So, I need the ocarina to open the cave doors. But Sonya lost it somewhere inside the cave. Okay. No, that might not be Sonya at all. I don't know. Oops. Only one place this ocarina could be found. So now we have a handy musical instrument, which I'm sure will be of importance to that door. Or medicine, whatever. Also, while I'm here, I will grab a... I'll grab a suit of armor. Yes. A chainmail. Yep. Keep in mind is that you have to stand completely still before you can access the menu. Otherwise, you just get this. So I guess you can't like change equipment while in midair, that sort of thing. Alright, so. So I'm gonna just go over here. Talk to Sonya, show her the ocarina. Oh, it's the ocarina. So, yes, I did. Alright, so yeah, the doors are sealed by the power of music. And I have to practice the melodies. Yeah, so... As you can imagine, the notes are tied to the Genesis controller. used to have these memorized, but I needed a refresher. Okay, so... Alright. So, Okay, I already forgot the melodies. I just have to... Oh, darn it. So... The game automatically stops you if you play a wrong note, so... Oops. Okay, so... Alright, there we go. That's one down. Another heart, and then a big heart. So definitely want to grab all of the hearts, because alright, I have mastered the ocarina, and my reward is a boss. Some more fire magic, and the cave has been, well, not the cave, but the village has been rescued from the threat of mushrooms. And we get this nice, pleasant music. Alright, so we gotta go see the queen. But first I'm gonna go ahead and grab a nap. Get the game saved. Because why not? Yes. Peaceful, but now we need to head to Purpril so we can rescue that princess. Alright. So, that's it. That's, we are never coming back here. But before we leave, let's take... Wait. There it is. The hidden money stash. Thank you. got this, I'm just gonna go ahead and call this a sewer level, because that's what it is. And I hate sewer levels. But yeah, mostly it's just, dealing with these blobby guys, and the bats, and, I use the spin here just because the, obviously that didn't, prevent the slime from jumping on me. This way, we're not going this way yet, not for quite a while. Just gonna keep moving. And next up, we've got a knight. Oh gosh, get away from me, knight. Alright. So this is the Princess of Purpril. Alright. She slowly saunters off. Now we can go all the way up this tower. I like how they have a little ladder at the top of that tall staircase. Okay, so this is something for later in the game. So, a quizzical sphinx. Alright, so yeah, that gate that we walked past the other a while back. Alright, so they're basically giving out hints for stuff for later in the game. So, things to keep in mind for next time. The princess is waiting. The princess is waiting. The princess is... Yeah, she is definitely waiting. Okay. Alright, so, Sheila Purpril thanks us for rescuing her. So, and she heard that we're on a journey and that we're battling the monsters in Monster World. So, okay, so next stop is the village of village of Lilypad. Damn it. Okay. So, alright. So now we're heading to another village. But first, we have to walk all the way back. And this part, I just slowly walk down the stairs. This isn't like some games where you can, like, you know, just hold the joystick down and then press jump to, like, jump below a ledge. You gotta just walk all the way down. All the way. And now we're in the city. Let's go ahead and top off our health. So now she's telling us about the desert, because it's forbidding. Alright, so... Actually, I just realized, shouldn't this guy be saying discerning eye, like you have a discerning eye? It's just a discriminating eye, it just sounds, well, sounds discriminatory. Makes Shine look like a jerk. That's all I'm saying. Alright, so Night Sword, yes, definitely want a new weapon. And let's see if I can get some hard armor. Nice. Okay, 220 gold. Yes, take that. So we got armor and, oh, I should have bought a shield. So, wait, no, I have a shield. No, I don't. Okay, well. You're very strong. I hope one day I'll be so strong. Whatever, kid. On my face. Alright, so this shop. I'm gonna need those ladder boots. Yes. And also the charm stone. 500,000 gold. Would I like to purchase it? No, I guess not. And yeah, charm stones are super expensive and, in my opinion, just a waste of money. Not to mention, it takes eons to farm that kind of cash. Let's put on the ladder boots. Now Shine walks like 5% faster, and the big plus of the ladder boots is that he can move up and down ladders very quickly. And also, I think there is a secret... No? No, it's not here, is it? Alright, so... The dwarf village, lily pad, yep. I believe there's supposed to be a secret door somewhere. Maybe I got it wrong. Maybe it's over here? No. Why would it... Because there's actually a shop where you can buy stuff with charm stones, but it's just like extra magic, and we don't use magic, so... Okay, next up. Woods. A lot of platforming and spiders. I think there is, yeah, a ghost. Yeah, we definitely don't want to fall in that, whatever that toxic stuff is. Unfortunately, I'm gonna have to farm for some more money because there's some new boots I wanna buy, possibly some armor, and hopefully a shield too. Because the next dungeon coming up can be a bit of a problem. here's a village. Now, this girl's younger brother, Hada, has been taking my monsters, okay? I don't see how that's our problem, but oh well. Okay, so marine boots. Oh, yeah. Now that's a... Well, that's gonna be a farm and a half. But I need the marine boots because, well, they make Cheyenne a better swimmer. Okay, so, shield, wow. Okay, I don't need that. That's a shield magic, but, obviously I don't have dosh for it, so. Alright, steel armor. Oh, God. Everything's so expensive. Well, at least the shield's kind of... Oh, whoops. That was an accident. So... Alright. Well, one of the children... I don't want to see anyone. Do me a favor and just go away. One of the children in his village, a village which apparently has two children total. So, understandable. Okay, now these... yeah. Now these guys definitely drop a nice bit of cash. Only problem is they hit hard, so I have to be mindful. They're throwing axes. And I believe this is the part where I... Oh, darn it. Or the first time I played the game, I died and had to do all the previous stuff over. So... Let me go ahead and... Actually... I do have magic. Why don't I just try using it? I don't need the ocarina anymore. Alright. So, ooh, the dwarf child is in danger. I survived, but that still went badly. Because magic... I still have the... Yeah, I have the elixir, so... Oh gosh, am I gonna die again? After all these years, I'm still dying in the forest. Yep. Oh gosh. This is what happens when I don't save at literally every end. I'm gonna do all that nonsense over again. Golly. And the worst part is that after this point, after the next dungeon, and I get out of the woods, and the difficulty of the game just kind of falls off a cliff until literally the very end. So, it's, it's an uneven game. Classic, uneven difficulty. And I forgot to buy the ladder boots. Oh well. means less farming for the marine boots later. Now I gotta do the slow climb. But yeah, the magic was useless. The medicine I bought earlier was refilled like a heart at the most. So, just, it was no good. Rescue operation was a big old mess. I gotta take a bath now. And it's a long one, too. Gosh. Nope. Okay. Again, just in case. So, and again, yes, yes. Especially seeing how the last inn I walked past ended up costing me dearly. Yeah. Okay, so, farming time. Actually, I have enough for the shield, so I'll go ahead and grab that. So far for the boots, and then, I guess that's it. Excuse me. Whew. Oh, just belted out a whopper of a sneeze. Whew. All right. just gonna get the 300 for those boots, and then we'll continue with the game. There's no way I'm just gonna sit around farming 800 bucks for the armor. Especially since money becomes a little bit easier to come by after after the next few areas. And also, nice thing about the shield is that I can just sort of jump into the flying axes and block them. Alright. Excuse me. Oh. Yeah. Alright, so, new boots. And the new boots also increase our walking speed, so it's very nice. Aside from that slight mishap, we're doing all right. Yeah, I'm just gonna go ahead and keep killing these guys though, because I need the money. Oh, that's right. Yeah, just jump over my attack. Darn it. So, yep, I see why. It's because the firestorm kept tracking the enemies that are actually invincible. So... So, Firestorm isn't completely useless, it's just useless in that one particular situation. Oh. Alright, so, I rescued the kid. Yep. Yep. I will take your eternal grateful day. Excuse me. Yep, Shion is a hero. So, now, we gotta meet Poseidon. From out of nowhere. Perpetual sleep at the bottom of the sea. Okay, so we need his trident. And the monsters have it. So. So we've got our next mission. Darn it. Yep. This dwarf's little brother. It kind of, just like, from a distance, it looks like he has three really large teeth. Like a really large, just massive set of chompers. But I think that also could just be like a beard. So, because, even dwarven boys have like full-length beards. Alright, so... first thing he does is he punches a hole in this temple that we can enter. So it's dark here, so let's just keep walking. And now we've got a bat. And I'm all turned around on it. Okay, so this Hada, his ability is that he can dig for gold, but the most he'll ever get is like 2 or 3 pieces, so it's nothing. Again, allies in this game are just, they're just there. It's companionship, that's all they, which is nice in itself. It doesn't feel like Shion's alone all the time. Alright, so let's just take him with us, just because. So, feels like I'm missing stuff. Like, I've been going at this for so long, and I still only have 4 hearts. Let me just see what's over here. So, if I didn't have an elixir, that treasure chest would have contained one. Instead, it just has a big heart. So, new shield. I wish there were some armor though. Oh. So, okay, yeah, there is a puzzle here. If I do them out of... Okay, so that's one right. That's two. Three. And then the four. Alright. So I fall down here, and another boss. It's Crag and Glag. Oh, this guy. These guys. Yeah, mostly it's just a matter of, whoop. One more hit. Alright, great stuff. And I got a trident. Now, I'll go ahead and equip. Now, I know I'm missing stuff, though. So I'm gonna save real quick and then head back. Because I really feel like I should be I should have 5 hearts by now. So I definitely took a wrong turn in that dungeon somewhere. Yeah, because last time I didn't... Oh, wait. Wait, I think I know what's up here. Yeah, drat. Yep. Okay, so I need that kid back so he can punch a hole in the wall, which leads to a room with another heart, I think. Yeah. Bit more blundering, but the results are worth it, because hearts are, they're essential, especially for the end of the game. Because if you've played through Wonder Boy Monster World, you know that the final boss is very tough, like inexplicably tough, tougher than anything else in the game by far. And so yeah, I want to make sure, yep, I've got all the hearts I can get. So, but now that we have the trident, we can explore the sea, and find all sorts of nice stuff. So I'm going to start by going over here, jumping into the water, and we get, which, in my opinion, best song in the game. Like, I hate water stages, but water stages always have good music. Secret door. Yeah, big money. And yeah, as you can see, the marine boots give Shion a lot of speed. And these crabs are just tanks. Nope. No secret door there. There's a secret door there. What's in the... Some more money, some hearts, and a big wad of cash. Merman to come down here. Give him a stab. Whoops. Oh, right, yeah, I gotta go to the other side of... Because the big treasure we want is right there. Out the right way eventually. All right, we have the pygmy armor. And unfortunately, we can't equip it because we're too big for it. It is an armor made for very tiny heroes. So we're not tiny yet. So head on over here. I feel like there is a secret. Nope. Okay, so there is a secret door somewhere, not there, but somewhere. So yeah, as you can see, there is a treasure chest, which is seemingly unreachable. Unreachable? A much-needed heart. There it is. Alright. Another big stack of cash. Down there. And secret money. Alright. Okay, I'm just equipping the sword so that way if I mess this part up, I just fall in the water and I don't sink to the bottom. Alright. Yeah, so the game actually forces you to spend the night if you want to save. So you're paying to save the game, essentially. I mean, it's a nominal fee, but still. So, I got a good bit of cash. And now, back. just get every last penny. Can't help myself. So there are a, there's another secret door, not here. Here. And it's another heart. So we are piling them up now. But we still need more. Like we can never have enough. Ouch. Especially when every little thing takes off half a heart. But yeah, we've still got plenty of deep sea exploration of. As the village chief or the mayor or whoever he wants to call himself said, there is a Poseidon. We gotta go meet Poseidon. He's apparently been having a nap while we're out. Thank you. maybe I don't need to stop and pick up every last dot. Down here again, this is a different attack. I lost track of the attack button. And now we have a pygmy sword to go with our pygmy armor. So, oops. Oops, double oops. Alright. Now, this helpful lady tells about an amulet, so we can find a shrine at the bottom of the sea, presumably where Poseidon is sleeping. So if I give her the ocarina, she gives me a clue about a door hidden amidst four palm trees. So. Now, knowing that you're not required to give her the ocarina, like, you could just, like, either figure this out on your own, or like, maybe if you're playing through the game again, and you know exactly where to go, but there's no reason to keep the ocarina. Plus, I accidentally hit the confirm button, so it's all moved. Anyway, we got an amulet. So, let me just make sure there's nothing cool down here. I don't know why these things have so much, such high defense. Big cash. I think this is just a dead end into nothing. Yeah, darn it. Oh well. Alright, there's nothing else here. At least not on this side. In the temple. Oh. These guys always jump after you attack them. Extra cash, and down we go. Now this dungeon has a lot of lot of fans that are going to be pushing us every which way, so. Alright. So we can't reach that, switch. We can reach this chest, which gives us another heart. There are more hearts that we can collect after, because even though it looks like we got a full set, the more hearts we collect, they start to overlap, and gotta keep flying into dead end, or swimming into dead ends, knocking out all the switches. Yeah, there is a treasure chest I'm missing. Now we've got the very useful return magic. This kicks us back to the last place we saved the game. Good for just kind of teleporting around, just getting back home quickly. Saves us a lot of hassle. Did a slick dodge and then just ran into an enemy. Oh gosh. Oh gosh, I am surrounded. I still have this awful medicine. Might as well use it. There are like a dozen tiers of medicine in this game, so. Just the first one I bought is the weakest. And skeletons again. Definitely needed after that beating I took from those mermen. Okay, I gotta be coming up. Yeah, I'm coming up on the end soon. Is this ever gonna end? No, it's not. Okay, fair enough. So I gotta find some switches. Not there. Don't want to go up there. Don't want to get sniped. Another dead end of nothingness. Whoops. monster. I'm doing well. How about yourself? Whoops. Just having a meeting with Poseidon, the legendary hero that I am. So now Poseidon's gonna send me to see a dragon. But first, I gotta find a Sphinx, whoops, to increase your shine strength. But I don't think it works like that, but alright. So the item that Poseidon's talking about is a pair of boots, which allow desert traversal. So, just get. Okay. This is Wonder Boy in Monster World for the Sega Genesis. Came out in like 1991, I believe, so it's a pretty old game. Alright, so the Oasis boots, that's what I needed. And use the return magic to get out of here. Trying to run past everything. There's really no point in just bashing everything for pennies. Whoops. Whatever. So, a new weapon shop has opened, so I can get Excalibur, which is a bargain. Steel shield, alright. Not exactly a steal at that price, but alright. Alright, so new shield, new sword, but I need new armor, so I'm gonna run back to the other village, which is luckily just a shortcut away. Armor, got a new sword. Now our next destination is the desert. So let me go ahead and save real quick, because otherwise hearts and armor we have, death is not exactly a big concern, but I just can't be too careful. Oh, wait. Okay, I got the boots on. Alright, because if Cheyenne isn't wearing the Oasis boots here, his health just Okay, just get pushed. He doesn't get pushed out. His health drains and drains until he finally dies horribly. Take out the scorpions, more snakes. Yeah, you always have to be mindful of where Cheyenne is standing. Because it just does not stop. Okay. Because Cheyenne can block any projectile that's, you know, that's, as long as it doesn't hit him in the head. You know. So, actually, I fall down here, and I get this. Suddenly sidetracked. Secret stash of money. Not that way. Alright, the quick magic does damage to all enemies. Well, not all enemies, all enemies that are on the ground. So naturally, bats and anything flying aren't harmed. Oh. And speaking of bats, I gotta kill all these little bats to make hidden platforms appear. I kind of hate this part just because it takes a second to line up the platforms. Go down here, pick up the shield magic, continue. Nothing here, alright. I keep thinking there's like secret doors everywhere. Okay, not this way yet. Spikes. Alright, yeah, I forgot. I need the sun key. Ow. believe that there is a secret door here, but maybe I'm wrong. So. Yeah, I'm probably wrong. Okay, so this room serves no purpose. Thanks. Alright. Well, whatever the case, I got a key, so... looking into one of these doors. That door. Alright. And so, our next... so we're in the Sphinx's Pyramid. Ghosts. Okay, so if Sean takes a hit here, he falls off the rope and all the way to the bottom. So let's try to avoid that. Picked up another key. And these mummies are annoying, because sometimes they just turn into daggers, and gotta go down, ow, darn it. Big guy. Never mind, I'll just stay up here and... no! Darn it. My clever plan. Oh, wow. I could have just done that. Okay. Boss time. Now this boss, you gotta gotta solve some riddles. He's got this thing for quizzes. Oh, seriously, wow. Alright, but then you've probably heard that by now. Yeah, I have. Okay. Tell you what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna ask you some questions. 5, to be exact. When you've answered them all correctly, I'm gonna send you into a new world. Alright. Are you ready? Here's the first question. What's the name of the queen in the elf village? Well, that would be Eleonora. Here's the second question. How much does a charm stone cost? Well, 500,000. Yep. Here's the third question. Which of these stores does not sell weapons? Oh no. Oh gosh. What? I need a jerk. What's the first type of magic you acquire? Okay, Firestorm, yeah. Darn it. I needed 2 sec. Okay, so after defeating Dragonglag, what did you receive? A Trident. Yeah, so. If I got them all correct, he'd give me some extra magic. But instead. So that's disappointing. That though. How was I gonna get bellissimo or like, I don't think I've ever got that question before. Unbelievable. So So we got the last of, no wait, not the last of the pygmy items. We still need the pygmy boots to complete the set. I'm gonna head back to this first door. Climb the ropes. Which of these shops doesn't sell weapons? Whatever. How can I keep track of all these highly detailed facts? Alright, so. Oh, and these things. You gotta be careful here, because. Careful. Because there's boulders and these guys chucking their dang spears. Okay, so we are now in the village of the dragons. Yes, definitely save and recover. Shopping at all, huh? Alright, so the lone NPC in this town has something to say. So yeah. Gotta go see the dragon. Alright. So, at last, I have met the Elder Dragon. So I need an old axe hidden in the ice world. So now I have a bracelet which can be used to enter an ice world. But before I do that, put that handy return magic, because I'm going to do a little something. I was hoping I could get through this area just a little bit faster, but the enemies are placed just in just the perfect spot where I can't jump over them and I have to... I have to fight each and every single one of them. Alright, so there is a cliff here that I'm gonna jump off of, shove over here to get the power magic. Now, the power magic, it doubles Shion's attack power, but it's only temporary. But it's extremely useful. Extremely, extremely useful for the endgame. So, go ahead and hit the end again. Since sleeping recovers Shion's health and magic, so I'm gonna have that return spell. Alright, oh yeah. I think the shops are open. No, they're not. Okay, fine. Alright. That's a shop? So what, the Elder Dragon wants to talk to me again? I already gave you the bracelet. Oh, okay. Alright, okay, so let's just get out of here. Alright, so our next destination, the Ice World, is just over here. We gotta backtrack through the sewers. Now we can finally take this this path, which I skipped past earlier. Stop moving. Oops. Just keep barking into these guys. Now, just want to make myself a little staircase here. Grab a heart. Can I? I don't think Cheyenne is fast enough, darn it. Yeah, his boots are too slow. Okay. So, the bracelet has begun to glow. Creates a flame that melts the seal. And we enter the ice world, which has the same music as the water world. Oh well. It is a lovely tune. As I said before, it's the best in the game. Well, actually... Okay, so I got 2 power magic, 2 shield magic. Okay. I want to try and get more power magic, because power magic is just so good. It's one of those spells that's good for any, well, for like boss fights and, watch out for the penguins. Now, unfortunately, this part of the game is kind of annoying in that the stuff for sale, it costs far more than what I can make. Like, it's just, unless I sat around farming penguins for an hour, there's no way I'd be able to afford most of the stuff that's for sale. But we'll see in a second. As soon as I get to a shop. Ouch. Ouch. Double ouch. I don't know why, but I keep looking every time I grab one of those gems. I keep thinking it's like, oh, did I get like permanent magic upgrades, or I think those just replenish like one stock of magic. Ghost gave me a push. Okay, so this village, sort of a like magic village. Ceramic boots, 4,000. Yeah, holy water. I'm that broke, okay. But yeah, the ceramic boots increase Cheyenne's speed ever so slightly, and I... Oh, that's all they do. I wanted to raise a little bit of there we go. Okay. I just wanted enough cash to buy that medicine. Alright, so a secret lies in the surface of the walls of the ice castle. Okay. And now, let's check out the weapon here. Battle spear. 10,000 gold. Yeah. No. So yeah, this is what I was talking about. A lot of this stuff is just, it's kind of prohibitively expensive. and the enemies here don't really drop enough money. And he gave me a... This wizard over here looks like he's giving me the finger. Just enough. So, back to 2 gold. Broke as a joke. Now we talk to her. Yep, Shine, legendary hero. So, alright, so we gotta go to the ice castle. Now, Shabo? Yeah, Shabo here. Okay, so that prince isn't gonna be relevant for a bit. Now Shabo here can throw his scythe at enemies when he feels like it. Tell because it's got that black mage look from Final Fantasy where you can only see the eyes. And since this is an ice castle, we get ice physics, so we're gonna be slip sliding all over the place. So yeah, this area can be pretty annoying because, you know, constant sliding around and sliding into spikes, sliding into enemies, getting pushed by sliding blocks and just constant sliding. Loud grinding noise. And of course the enemies jump here, because of course they do. Alright, so we go up here, and... Oh gosh. And I get pushed out. I'm just gonna set the return magic. In case it looks bad, I'll teleport out. But hopefully it doesn't come to that, but it probably will. I'm just getting bonked every which way. Of course he drops a big heart, so that stinks. And we got the pygmy boots at least. Whoop. What's in here? Oh, wait, no. I don't want to do this yet. Get a running start. Another long jump. I hate this place. I hate this place so much. Just constant slipping and sliding, and getting pushed into enemies, and pushed away from enemies. And so I go in here, facing on the one of these jerks. Another big heart. And then another heart. And as you can see, that heart just kind of overlaps with the rest of them. This place is just so evil. All the ice physics, all in one place. Like most platformers, they'll have the slippery platforms, or like some platforms are ice, some aren't. But this dungeon, it's just all ice all the time. And this thick, it's thick. That's his whole plan of attack. He just rushes in and starts stomping on me. Okay, so I got a blue gem. Let's get another one of those hearts. One of the few convenience. Ice physics, why are there ice physics? Well, as I was about to say, one of the few conveniences of this dungeon is that those two creatures, darn, in the top right and left corners, drop hearts. So now we go down here, and we're going to find another big boy. Let's try this quake magic. Oh, it sucks. Okay. Gotta do this the hard way. Moving. And this one drops an elixir, which is very nice. And we get the gold gem. So I just want to pop in here, grab another heart. Nope. Why do I even try? Why do I even... Nope. constant. Nope. Of course. And that scythe of Shabos just doesn't do anything. Trying to get out of here. I'm trying. Because I don't want to be here any longer. There we go. Alright, so now I just gotta do some precision platforming. Oh. Sean inserts the gold gem. Okay. Cheyenne inserts the blue gem. Okay. So, we have opened a door to another elevator, and we're about to face the next boss. The ice bomber. I don't get this look of his. Like, I get the snowman aesthetic, but why has he got the Indian headdress? The merit Indian headdress. But it's not much of a fight. As you can see, he's already almost dead. It's just a matter of getting that last hit in. Ice fit. And drops a nice bit of cash. And the old axe. I see. He dropped a tomahawk. Thanks. I don't get any of this. Alright, so we're essentially done here, but So the old axe is useless, essentially, but... Alright, so we gotta go to Begonia, which is the Dragon City, and see their blacksmith. Excuse me. Yeah, take another nap. In here, buy some armor. We're getting close to the point of the game where all the best stuff we can get isn't stuff we can purchase. So, let's get out of here. Visit to the Elder Dragon. So, you've managed to get your hands on the old axe. Alright, so, go see the blacksmith. And we get this dragon's grandson for help. Now, the Dragon is probably the most useful ally, which unfortunately isn't saying much, but he'll actually go after enemies and attack them. He'll do things. Alright, so... this old axe can be used to create a sword, but we also need a necessary item. But yeah, that's very helpful, blacksmith. Yeah, a necessary item. You can at least tell me what it is. But, okay. So, this random guy, this random dragon guy, saw someone with the fire, the item I'm supposed to get. So, they're heading into a volcano. Now, this volcano has a very, very small door, which, but lucky for me, I collected all of the pygmy equipment, so, so the pygmy sword, pygmy armor, pygmy shield, and pygmy boots. Yes, the requirements have been satisfied. So let's get in there. Alright, we are now small. And we are so small that a baby dragon is taller than us. And plus our attack range is practically non-existent. Just, wow. Okay, but the nice thing about being small is that we can move through small passages. So let's find ourselves a small passage to fit through. So I know one right off the bat. We'll just go over here. Pieces. Right. So that's that. So I want to head back to the pyramid, because there is more treasure to collect. Yeah, unfortunately the pygmy sword is quite a bit weaker than my last weapon, so enemies are going to be taking more punishment for this part of the game. Yeah, fall down here. Falling, and then look at that. That's one shortcut. I go down here. I got a few doors. Now, this room has a lot of treasure chests. A lot of money. Well, 1945, that's an interesting, alright, so, I'll try falling down here, and then here, I get a little bit of cash. And yeah, essentially, I'm just repeating the same area over and over again to get all the treasure. Including a charm stone. Considering these charm stones are $500,000, you'd think they'd be useful for something, but not quite. Alright. So, I think there was just, just that treasure chest right there. Which I can get by going here, down here, and then, yeah. Alright. So, a nice little haul. Alright. Nothing to do here, so let's head to the volcano. Advantage of the inn. Oh, we had something of a growth spurt overnight. That's nice. So the high potion restores all of Xion's life, and obviously it's pretty dang expensive. But yeah, so the volcano, it's doubly annoying because, well, one, it's a fire stage, and two, you're tiny, so a lot of this area is just going to be, okay, that's four power spells, that's nice. Come on, just going to keep moving. Nope. Ow. Oh, forget it. But most of the time, it's just not worth fighting, just because everything is hard to hit when you're, like, tiny, tiny, tiny. Which is too bad, really, because the enemies drop good amounts of money. Land on the platform. No. So, definitely having a rough time thus far. But yeah, let's try the fire magic. Yeah. So that was pretty pointless. Snakes. How can such a big snake drop such a tiny heart? Birds, more birds. I hate the birds. No sense messing with that, that fire snake. Big wad of cash. So down here, snakes, a lot of snakes. Trying to hit anything with this sword, it's the worst. Alright, thank you. I don't want to fall down there just yet. Just check what's in here. Oh, the exit. What? Okay. Luckily it doesn't kick me back to the beginning or something. I probably would have flipped. Some more, just a couple more of these guys. And now we got the boss. An evil dragon. Oh, whoa. so we can try out that power magic. And our attack range is so pitiful that... Stunk, but at least it's over. We got a fire urn, so we can get our new sword. Get out of this horrible tiny body. Alright, so let's go see the Elder Dragon one last time. Alright. So, gotta go back to Purple Castle, and we're heading into the last stages of the game. We got the best sword in the game, but first we gotta take a quick nap. Alright. So, the legendary sword. It's awesome, it's got a star on it. Let's go ahead and we'll go ahead and buy some armor and a shield and alright, looking good. Of course, since we're heading into the final dungeon, all the best equipment in the game is gonna drop there. So this is really just for show, and I don't have anything else to spend money on. Alright, so go over here, we find the princess. Yes, I'm really going. What? Woman, I don't even know you. Yeah. Like, we've literally met once. And you're gonna play that stable. So yeah, this part, I gotta be careful, because otherwise I gotta redo it, and that's not fun. There we go. Okay, another heart. Good. Alright, so. Great start. So the final dungeon is essentially split into two parts. We're doing part one now. The part two is way on the other side. Behind that electrified barrier. Now this part, kind of a maze where you have to choose the right path. When I played through Dragon's Trap a while back, I figured the right way was always the path of most resistance, so we're going to see if that holds true in this part of the game. So, we want to take whichever path has like the most enemies or the most obstacles. Into these things. Ow. Go up here, and did I make a mistake? I don't know, I can't really tell. All look the same. Okay, I'm on the right track. Speaking of tracks, we've got a minecart section. The standard duck to dodge the spikes. Grab this treasure chest because it has the legend boots. And now, we are flying. We're like super fast now. But unfortunately, since we jumped off the minecart, we gotta fall down. Let me just pop over here, see if there's anything useful. Probably not. Whoops. Nothing changes. We still can't get up there. But now we're small. Boy. There's probably a narrow crevice we can slip through. But first we gotta fall. Jump over these guys. It's obviously not worth fighting them because small Cheyenne is just, he's just a pain. It's no use. And he doesn't have to crouch, that's nice. Just wait, coming coming on up to the jump. I'm tempted to fall, but at the same time, I'm not. Oh. Well then, what? What was the point of all that? Alright, up here? No, we don't. We go over here first. Because I got a chest, but yeah. This is the one part we use the Quake magic. And we get the Legend Shield. Anything over here? No, there isn't. It just loops around. But of course you gotta kill him, so I use the crouching attack. Dragon. So this part, I'm missing the armor, so I gotta figure out where the armor is. Thank you. just standing in them. I don't have to jump. Wish I knew that a second ago. Alright, so, land on the platform, avoid the snake. To do this without. So this is the Almighty Demon King. This isn't happening. Oh. And yeah, I can't switch magic. Ugh. Costs us dearly. So I gotta do all that stuff again. Yeah, there are like 3 points in this game I die at. The very, very beginning, the second to last boss, and the last boss. I should have found that armor first and maybe ran back and saved, and I gotta repeating all the same mistakes. Yeah, this stinks. Yeah, clearly the part where Shion shrinks is important for something. I'm sure it's related to getting the best armor, but so I gotta do all that again. It's becoming something of a trend because I died on the final boss when I played through Wonder Boy the Dragon's Trap earlier. have those boots again. And I kept pausing during the boss fight because I thought I could just go into the main menu and grab the return magic and just escape, but it doesn't work like that. It does not work like that. So I gotta find the narrow passage that this transformation is good for. So I think what I might try is falling into one of those falling into that big hole from earlier. Yeah, this hole. Let's see what's... Okay. Oh! Well, there it is. The legend armor. Literally right there. And then a heart. Wow. Yeah, if only I stopped here earlier. I'd have saved myself a... I don't know if it would have saved my life, but it definitely would have made a difference. So, okay. This is the path to nowhere, so I want to get out the quake magic. Alright, yeah, so these guys again. I want to believe that this dragon can drop big hearts as well as big money, so maybe he'll drop a heart and I stop landing on me. Try that again. Maybe it's not gonna happen. Alright, forget it then. reduce that part. Just a big heart waiting for me at the... And, okay. Alright, so, power magic. Oh no, I'll just wait. I don't wanna... Really? So I can't. All right. Okay. Fine. 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 All right. So here's the Prince of the Dark World, who talks very slowly. Yes, I'm the legendary hero, yes, yes. So he was the under control of Biomecha, a deadly creature from outer space. But I'm alright now. Thank you for coming to my aid. Okay, so... So now we can go this way, but we're not, because... So, well, I still had the elixir, so it wasn't that critical, but still awfully close. And I gotta take the long way down. Oh. Make sure I got, alright, yeah, I've got the healing potion. I'm just gonna save. I'm gonna save because, gosh, do I need to save. Because the final boss is even tougher. And luckily I was able to push the Demon King back into the corner and land a lot of good hits in. So that helped immensely. But, because large stationary targets, where you have to jump and hit them, it's kind of tough, especially in this game, just because you got the pitiful attack range, and you gotta keep jumping at enemies, hoping that your hit lands, and you don't just keep getting creamed repeatedly. But all right. Get the long elevator into space, and then we get a spaceship, which is pretty sweet. Alrighty. Now this part. It's filled with, like, aliens. So, aliens, plus we refight all of the bosses. But, the boss refights are easy because, look. They didn't adjust the enemy stats for Xion having, all the best armor and weapons and stuff. So, everything dies in like 3 hits. I Now this guy dies in one hit. So nothing to talk about there. This the ice bomber again. I got the best weapon, so 4 hits. So the tyrant dragon was a lot of problems, but that's only because we were small. Now that we were big, he dies in record time. So at this point, do I want to go all the way back and save? Which means going back to Earth or Monster World. Because right here, up this long ladder, is the final boss. But, yeah, I'm just going to save because... Just going to save... Which I know is boring, but I can't be too careful. Because literally every time I haven't saved, I've gotten punished for it. At least this way, if I die, I don't have to redo all the bosses. And even if they do die in like less than 5 hits, it's still... Although I hate this part, I really do. After the fourth or fifth time doing this, I'm just like, come on. Just couldn't give me a shortcut, just let me jump off the tower and into town. The next game in the series, Monster World 4, doesn't have ends at all. Instead, it just has a mysterious old man who shows up every now and then to let you save the game. He's he's far more convenient because he'll show up like in dungeons and right before bosses. It's pretty nice. Sometime soon, I want to tackle Monster World 4. But first, I gotta finish this. Take the long elevator. Hop in the spaceship. like the look of the spaceship. It looks like something from, like, Phantasy Star 2. Looks like it has eyes, though, on the... Alright, so... A ladder... Okay, it's not that long. Alright, so, magic, we want power. We want... Alright, so this thing, I can't do anything. Like, it's got too much armor. Then he shows up. Some hero. Is that the best you can do? Well, watch this. He just runs into the... Not too bad, eh? Now let's see if you've got what it takes. So, I get my health back, which is good, and he died. Well, he doesn't die, but... Alright, so, this is the first half, which luckily isn't too much trouble, but then this is where it gets dumb. See, I can only hit it when its eye is open. And all the while there's this conveyor belt and buzz saws, and I forgot to equip the gosh, come on. Yeah. So, okay, so the story with the final boss is that, in the Japanese version of this game, the final boss is actually easier. Like, I forget the specifics. Like, I don't know if they took out the saw blade, or there's no conveyor belt, or what, but the boss is... It's significantly easier. But for the Western version, Sega's like, we need a harder final boss. And well, mission accomplished. Worst part is I could have taken him, but I forgot to equip the dang potion. The dang potion, which I spent $5,000 on. Luckily, that's why I saved. But yeah, not a fan of this final boss, because it's already enough trouble hitting enemies, because Shine's got that dumb sword, and it's lousy range, and... Okay. Alright. Got my power, and my potion. That's right, just shoot me again. Hurry up. One more. Some hero, is that the best you can do? Well, watch this. Not too bad, eh? So, okay. Let's try that again. Because I'm pretty sure I've got what it takes. It just sometimes... Good riddance. Immediately jump to credits. Yep, final boss is dead. Another whopper sneeze. Allergies. You know how it is. Alright, but yeah, that's Wonder Boy Monster World. Overall, good game. Not without its frustrations, of course. But that's mainly just because Shion, it's kind of a clunky little guy to control and just attack enemies with. And so now we get the ending. We got the credits and then the ending. And now we get to meet with, you know, see all of the characters one last time. Well, not all the characters. Apparently the shopkeepers couldn't be bothered to step outside. But yeah, it's like, it's a fine adventure game. It's got, the level design's really good. Lots of solid platforming. Oh, except the Ice Palace. But that's, I guess that's more an issue of the game's underlying mechanics, just with the way Shion moves and attacks and stuff. It doesn't lend itself well to certain aspects of the game. But if you took away, like, what makes the main character who he is, then it kind of ruins the game's identity. In the end, this is a Monster World game, so it's kind of part and partial to have the main character have a very short range attack and not a lot of options to really get around that. Like, there's magic, but it's limited in usage, and so. Some final boss runs off, laughs it up. We get a little to be continued. But still, it's a good game. It just, I don't know. It's just the end. It doesn't really stick the landing just because it has the two very tough final bosses. And that's part of the what gets me about games is, like, just having a bad finale or a frustrating finale. It kind of takes away from the rest of the game. Because if you ever play the game again, you're like, oh, well, shoot. I mean, I like this game, but then the final boss, and you spend the entire game dreading that encounter. And that's part of what happens in Monster World. Because it's like, everything up to, you know, going through the various worlds, exploring, collecting treasure, that's all well and good, but in the back of your mind, you're still thinking about that final boss. But other than that, good stuff. I'm gonna, take a break. So y'all have a good one and take care.